When a city like Melbourne and a neighborhood like South Bank is experiencing the transformation that it has been over the last decade and is continuing to do, it makes really good sense to bring in a lot of different perspectives and also to make sure that whatever's put forward happens in a very well-informed way.
When we received the leaflet regarding the sale of the site, a lot of people threw it to one side saying, it's South Bank, it's not going to work. But when I saw the size of the site and the immediate context of the site, I saw potential in there. I started dreaming about what we can do. As property developers, we have a great responsibility in shaping the city. It's not a one-person job. It's important to engage, you know, a great consultant team to help you deliver that vision.
We wanted the best for the site, not just best for Melbourne, but best from the world. And therefore, we created an international design competition.
Creating a competition draws out the best in everyone, and it really pushes people to think outside the box. You know, it challenges the designers to push boundaries, to really see what can be done rather than just having a cookie-cutter solution.
The buzz around the competition is totally different, and that gives it a kind of extra dimension to not only want to be the winner of the competition, but also try to contribute to the dialogue about the development of South Bank and Melbourne.
Well, what is also interesting about this location and about this brief, this project, all these conditions, is the opportunity to make connections to the network of conditions and institutions that are already there.
It's much better than all other competition. The clients see how you act. The jury can put you questions, otherwise you are dreaming a little bit, and then they say, oh no, it's far away from that what we wanted. So this is very good. It will be a beautiful site after we have finished the building, because the concept is very good.
The competition will be overseen by a jury of 7 members, and each of them are a highly esteemed individual in the design fraternity.
The caliber of each of our jurors is such that they have all seen a lot of architecture. They have judged a lot of buildings in a lot of different contexts. So I think each of our jurors will bring really quite a different perception of what's good about each project. It will be my job to guide the principles against which we judge the projects, hopefully capture the key issues that each juror brings to the conversation.
We have shortlisted 6 global architects, and each will have to work with a local architect so that we have international and local ingredients in the design.
So the architects that we've shortlisted are architects from all around the world. They are known to defy convention. That's one of the common quality for all these architects. They're known to break the rules, push the boundaries, and create something that's really extraordinary. And these firms include Bianca Ingalls Group, paired with Fender Katsalidis, Coupe Himmelblau, paired with Architectus, Matt Architects with Ellenberg Fraser, OMA with Conrad Gargett, MVRDV paired with Woods Bagot, and UN Studio paired with Cox.
They have 12 weeks to propose the design, and within the 12 weeks we have a mid-stage review where each firm come to Melbourne and present their concepts. And after 12 weeks they will submit their report and come to Melbourne to present to the jury. The jury will select a winning design and announce it in August.
You have to be examined by history in next 200 years. What the future generation be proud of when they look back.
Once we shortlist the winner, we will go straight into it. We'll get the ball rolling straight away. We'll start to work with all the relevant authorities to make this concept a reality.
We are very excited about the competition and very excited to see the designs from each entrance, and really excited to choose a design that will be great for Melbourne.
To engage this series of thinkers in this operation and to find out, therefore, the best answer. And hopefully also an inspiring answer with such a kind of, say, intensity that you will change that area and that you will get the attention, that you will attract the river to that area.